Okay, today we will see about in detail of the resource file and how, if you click on the particular view, how it will works and what is the thing you need to do if you click on the view particular view. Okay, so as I told, in the resource folder will be present in the Android view. Okay, in the Android view, the resource folder will be there. That is called as RES folder will be there. Within that, you will be having a drawable folder for images and icons, and layout folder for layout resource files, and menu folder for menu items, and mipmap folder for your app icons that you use to launch for the app, and values where you can define colors, dimensions, strings, and styles. So predefined things you can do in this values folder. Okay, so how to use that? So such syntax to refer the resource in XML layout file is how you are going to refer the what you have defined in the resource folder. The syntax is @ package name resource type colon resource type slash forward slash and with the followed with the resource name. So what is this package name? So package name is name of the package in which the resource is located. It means that so what resource you want to refer, from which package you want to refer, you need to specify the package name, that is package name. So when you are referring a resource within the same package, there is no necessity to use the package name. So if you are referring the resource from one package to another package, then you need to specify this @ package name. Okay, then colon resource type. So resource type is R subclass. So it's we call that resource type is R subclass for resource type. So what type of resource you are going to use? So that is a resource type. So then forward symbol, forward slash followed by the resource name. So resource name means whatever, if you want to refer the name or any color or any style, okay, or any text. So that is the resource name. So let's see with an example. So for example, the XML layout statement will be like that. Android colon text. So text is an attribute. Okay. @ string forward slash button underscore label underscore toast. So what is this @? So here we have not specified the package name because the resource is stored in the string.xml file. So string is a resource type. Okay. So and the resource name will be button underscore label underscore toast. Okay. So here we are not using any package name because within the same package only we are referring the resource. So what is values resource file? So I have said that you will refer those resources. So what you need to give? So what values you need to give? So keeping the values such as strings and colors in separate resource file. See, for example, so you want one, you need to define your own color where that color is used in your project so many times. So for every time you may not give same RGB code for every value wherever you want. So what you will do, you will define that color in one particular place and then you will refer that particular color for your overall project wherever it is necessary. So keeping your values as a strings and colors in separate resource files. Okay, so for colors, there is colors.xml file. Within that, you will define that particular color. So that resource will be used in your project XML file. Okay, activity underscore main.xml file. So string, if you have any particular strings where you need to refer. See, for example, there is a string called welcome. So where this welcome string is going to use in your project so many times. So every time you keep on typing welcome, so that's not good practice as a developer. So what you need to do, you need to define that in strings.xml so that you can use it. Okay, so that is the values resource file. So next is strings. So I have said strings and colors. Let's see what is strings and then we will see what is colors. So string resources are located in string.xml file, where this XML file is present in values folder, where this values folder is present in resource folder, that is RES folder. Okay. So how this file will be there? By default, this is the values will be, some of the strings will be there. So how you are going to define? So within the resource tag, you need to give string name is equals to whatever the name you want, you give your here, and which text you need to use. So that text you need to give over here and close with the string. Okay. See, here there is a string called button label count. Okay. So the text is count. So I am using this text for my text view count. So then, for example, here, see here, Android colon text at the rate string button underscore label underscore count. So if you use like this in your display, it will show count. Okay. So the string value of this name is word count. So enclose with the string tags. See, so how you need to extract this hard coded string. So you are going, if you want to need to extract the hard coded string in the XML layout file, so what you need to do, so wherever it is required, so for example, in this image, it is showing here. So if you just right click on this value, so in this value, if you just right click, okay, so right click, you will get this dialog box. So then it will show extract string resources. Okay, so extract string resources. So here, see, the three steps. First, you need to extract the string resources, that is hard coded string. So for that, you can press Alt Enter, or you can click on that particular value. So if you click on that extract resource, this dialog box will get up here. Okay, here also you can change the name. Resource name, button underscore label underscore count. So this resource value you can change over here. Okay, you can edit the resource name for the string value, and if you click OK, that will be added to your string.xml. Okay, so next about colors. So as I said earlier, so for particular color you want, you need to use. So how you are going to give the values for that particular color? Where you need to locate the color resource? So if you want to locate the color resource, you need to use colors.xml file, where this will be same. It will be present in the values folder. The values folder will be in the RES folder, that is a resource folder. So by default, some of the values will be there over within that colors.xml. So if you want to add your own color, you can add. Okay. So where this color name will be in the form of hexadecimal values. Okay. For with the hash symbol. So what is this hexadecimal value? How you need to specify the hexadecimal values? Through RGB colors, red, green, and blue. So whatever the values you will give within this colors.xml, the values should always begin with the hash character, followed by alpha, red, green, and blue information. Okay, and blue. Alpha, red, green, and blue. So this is how you need to follow the code to give your own color in the colors.xml file. Okay, so next about dimensions. See, dimensions means, so how much dimension you need for your particular view. So which view you need to give dimensions. So if you want to give your own dimensions, so where this dimension resource is located in dimensions.xml, same this dimensions.xml will also same in the values folder, where values folder is present in the RES folder, that is resource folder. So there will be some of the values like this. So if you want to give same, just keep the cursor over here and enter, and with the tag dimen diamond space with the name is equals to name, whatever the name you want you give, and you can give the size. DP means device independent pixel, SP means scalable pixel. Okay. So this is how you need to give Android. See here in the previous. So there is activity horizontal margin, activity vertical margin. So here they have used at the rate dimension activity underscore horizontal underscore margin. Okay, where it is been enclosed with the diamond tags. Okay, same how you extract the string, same wise you can extract and you can give the name dimension value. So click on that particular hard coded dimension, or you can give Alt Enter in Windows, and for Mac OS, it's an option written. So select extract dimension resources. You will get a dialog box. There you can enter the resource name and the dimension value. So DP are independent of screen resolution. So DP will be whatever the DP you will mention, that will be of independent of screen resolutions. Okay. So whatever I thought, let's see with the practical. So how we should give all those things. Okay. Okay, I have defined some of the things. Okay. See. For example, here I will specify Android colon text. So I will give enter number 1. Okay. So I want to give it as a string. So what you need to do, you just hard code. See, if you click on the mouse, hard code string should use @ string resource. See, whenever whichever code line, in wherever the code line is there, you just move the cursor over here. It will give a suggestions what it is, or it will give an information what particular line it is. Okay, I will, what I will do, I will alt enter. See here, if I click alt enter, it will show extract string resources. If you don't click alt enter, you just click right click on that particular value and show content action and extract string resources. See, enter number 1. So I will change this, enter number underscore number 1. So file name will be string.xml. Okay. See, as soon as you click OK, it has been changed to the resource pool. Resource. So if we check where it should be there, it should be in the string.xml file. So where that string.xml will be there? In the values. Values will be in the resource folder. So values, strings.xml. See, whatever you have been hard coded, that is present in the strings.xml file. Same wise for color also. So let's see within color. So I will take text color. Okay, I will give ash okay. I will give some colors. See, if I click, I will click alt enter, extract color resource. So give the resource name, my color. I will give my color. Okay, where it will be present? File name color.xml. Okay. So see, as soon as you give, it has been changed to the path. It has been changed as a resource. So let's check with the color.xml. See here, whatever the color I have been mentioned, it is there here. Okay. See, next time if you want to use here, see for example, I have used the same color for here. No. So for my one more view, I need to use the same color. What I will do for text color, see what it should be there, @color / my color. Let's look for it. See here, the color is there. Double click, you will get. Understanding? Okay. This is how you need to use it. Let's see with responding to view clicks. Okay. See, what is this view clicks? See, for example, if your view is button or image view or image button or any floating action button. So if you click on that button, what action should take? So if a user taps, or if a user clicks on that particular clickable view. Clickable view may be a button, clickable view may be an image button or image view or any other palette or any UI interaction. Okay. So what it should do? So that is a click event. So that if you click on that click event should occur. Okay. For this, model view presenter pattern is useful. How you need to understand this? To understand this click event, you should know model view presenter pattern, how it is going to respond for a particular user click. So when an event occurs, it means that when a click occurs from the user side, okay, with a view, that is a view, so the presenter code performs an action that affects the model code. So the what the presenter will do, presenter will perform the action what the code which is written in the model. Okay. So what you need to do, how you need to make work on that. So in order to make this pattern work, you should write a Java code where it should perform some specific action. See, for example, if you want to perform an add function, you need to write the Java code so that it performs the addition function. Okay. So if you want to count the values, you need to write the logic for counting purpose, then it performs the counting actions. So that event occurs where it determines by the model code, what logic of the model you have been written in the Java code. So that is, action depends on what you want to. Okay, so what you want, that event will occur. So for this, we will refer this as event handler. Okay, that is, you will say it as an event handler. So where the associate this event handler method to view. So this presenter will communicate with the model and then it will display back to the view. The method executes when the event occurs. Okay, so use. So how you need to use this click? So how you are going to use click function? How you are going to make the click event occurs? For that, you need to use Android:onClick attribute, where with the clickable view elements, where you need to use this attribute. So if you want to click on the button, within the button view, you need to use this attribute, that is Android:onClick. So for example, in this, I have taken some example, let's show toast. So some toast it has to show. So that is an event handler. So how you need to use Android:onClick attribute is equals to show toast. So when the button is tapped, this attribute calls, this particular onClick attribute will call to the method show toast. So what is this method? This is the method where you are going to write the logic within the Java. Okay, so here with the event handler such as toast method reference in the XML code, call the methods implemented in the apps model. So this is whatever the method you give, that should be public only. Show toast, view. That is a view, no, button is a view, where it is a view. So in order to work with the Android click attribute, show toast method must be public and it should return only void. Where? And it also requires a parameter in order to call the method, that is view. Okay. So how you are going to create a method? So in this XML file, you are going to write an attribute onClick and you write show toast. So you need to create a function over there. So as soon as you write onClick on the XML file, it gives an error. So for that, what you need to do, that Android Studio provides a shortcut how to clear that error. Okay, so how to clear that error? So wherever the error is coming, it will show it in a red color. Keep the cursor over in that particular error line and press Alt Enter. It will give a suggestion. So inside the XML field, click on the method name, Android:onClick attribute statement. See, in the second step, you need to press Alt Enter. So then it will show a pop-up, create onClick event handler. So as soon as you click on the onClick event handler, it will choose an activity associated with the main activity, then click OK. So if you click OK with that, it creates a placeholder method within the main activity dot Java. Okay, so that is how you need to respond with the onClick method. So next, onClick attribute. How you need to update it? How you need to extract that? Okay, so to update the view, such as replacing the text in a text view. Okay, so to refer the view in your code, you should use a method called findViewById. Okay, so ID is an unique attribute it can be uniquely identified each view. So in the view class, it can be identified through the method findViewById. Okay, where view is based on the resource ID. What the resource ID you have been given in the activity_main.xml file. So with an example, I have set the mShowCount to be the text view with the resource ID showCount. So mShowCount is equals to text view. What is this view? That is a text view where I need to find the resource ID by method find view by ID. So how we are going to find with the resource class? How we are going to find the resource class through the ID? So what is the name of that ID? That is a show underscore count. Okay. From this point, your code represents the text field. Okay. So one more example with an onClick attribute, that is count up. See, I have taken a count up where as soon as you click on the button, it should get counted. So there is a small piece of code with the logic, that is mCount++. If mShowCount is not equal to null, so mShowCount.setText integer to string mCount. So let's see with an example. So let's see with an example.
Inna blaule. In Priya kumbi brush door maklave. Ramyumbi. Ramyu onda bo nista patala. Adu manager agota ki. Adu dikkata laramiya.
Okay, let's see with an example. So what I will do, I will remove all the whatever the written code I have. Let's see with the first point. Okay. So here I have used in relative layout, whichever the layout you want, you can use. Okay, relative layout I have taken. So let's go with the design part. So for example, I need to add two numbers and I need to display a result. Okay, I need to add two numbers. I need to display the result. So how we are going to do? See, whatever the thing I am explaining, so you need to know how it can be used, how ID should be used, okay? How you need to use in the Java code also, okay? So to enter the numbers, okay, to enter the numbers, you need edit text. Okay, you need edit text. So for that, I will be taking a plain text so that you can edit text. So if it is relative, you need to make a relative with the layout where your edit text should display. So I will make over relative to the right and I will make over relative that particular edit text to the bottom so that I can drag and drop wherever I require. Okay, I am making the relative of this view to the right and bottom. Okay, so next, for this one number I need to enter one more number. I will take one more edit text. Okay, I will make relative same like this. I will keep over here. Okay, then and one more view I need to display the result. To display the result, I can have a text view. I can have a text view where I will make a relative. I will make relative like this. Make adjustments. Okay. Then, so for entering two numbers, I have taken two edit text, and to display the result, I have taken one text view. To perform action, what we need to do, we need button to perform action. That is, on click event should occur. So for that, I am going to take a button. Okay, I am making a relative to the right and bottom. So I will keep over here so that we can perform the action. Okay. So I have done with the design part and I will look at with the, see whatever the you have been drag and drop, all the views has been placed. So first I will make, see in edit text, what you need to enter, you need to enter a number. So you don't need this. So I will make use of hint. Okay. So I will plus, I will give the value enter number one, and in the same next edit text, I don't want the text here. I will give the hint enter number two. Okay. So what is this? I will see, this is the ID. So whatever the ID you change, you should remember this because this is the main thing you are going to communicate with the code. Okay. ID is a resource. Okay, I will make this ED1, edit one, and I will make this ED2. Okay. The next text view is there. So text view is what purpose I am using? For result purpose. So I will give it as RES. So in the text view, I don't need any text to have. I will give a name that is result. Okay. So what is the button is for? Button is for addition. I will give add underscore button V2. Okay. So here the text should be not a button. I am performing addition operation, so I will give addition. See. See here, enter result add. It has been changed. Okay. So what I am going to explain here. I need to perform action on this button. As soon as I click on that particular button, so it should perform addition operation. For that, I need to use an attribute on click is equals to what action you need to perform? Addition operation. Okay, addition operation. See, you are getting an error in the red color. It shows a verb symbol. Click or press Alt Enter. Whatever the convenient you can do, I will click over here. See here, it is giving a suggestion, create add view in main activity. I will click OK. See, it's automatically created. So the error is gone now. Correct? So next thing, what I need to do, I need to go for a code. Within the main activity, I need to create method views, that is ED1, ED2, whatever the resource you have been entered. Yes. There is one text view, that is, I have taken the name as RES. Then there is a button that is add. Okay. So within the onCreate, function, you need to find the resource. How you are going to find ED1 is equals to find view by ID with where you need to see as soon as you give. @ID int ID. So r.id. So it will give a suggestion. So what the name you have been given in the XML file, it gives a suggestion. So I will find the first edit text. Then I will click enter. Okay. So next ED2 is equals to find view by ID r.id. Next edit text ID2 with the colon. So next I have a text view where I have taken it as RES is equals to find view by ID r.resourcefile. Through the ID I am going to find the text view. So that is what I have given RES colon. Alright. I have defined all these things. So what I need to do? I need to perform the action. So warning is showing. So this is edit text. And this is also edit text. This is text to view. The text. Okay. So here, see, as per your design, you need to enter two numbers. So for two numbers, what you need to do? The logic for addition logic, what is the logic? You should have a two numbers, and for display purpose you should declare one more variable, two variable for entering number one and one number two, and one more variable to display the results. I will take int a1 is equals to integer dot parse int. Okay. So pass in. So what is the ID? That is ED1.toString. So first you need to get the string, then you need to give toString dot get text dot toString. Okay, so why you are passing? Because here, whatever you enter, it's an edit text. It will be in a text format. If you enter number also, we take it as a text. So that's why you're going to pass the integer. So next, int a2 same is equals to integer dot pass in next edit button. So you need to fetch the value from number one and number two. So that's why next edit text dot get the text dot to string. Okay. So then what you need to perform int result. So I will take one more variable to display the results. So I will give result is equals to a1 plus a2. So this is enough. Now what you need to do, what you need to perform, you need to set text, correct? We need to set the text. So how you are going to set the text? One second. Okay. So here I will set it as, so where you need to display that, res dot okay, for convenient purpose I will change this to text one so that it will not get confusing, because so many times I have used res, so that's why we can have the text one. So text one dot set text. If you give same number, you cannot have a property. So plus what is the variable to this that is storing the answer, that is res. Okay, this is how. So let's run and see. I have connected the mobile, my mobile, so that I will get run and see. See, I will run it. So you can see the process, Gradle build running. So let's see how, if you click that button, on click event handler, how it occurs. Okay, sorry. So I need to use, I need to connect my mobile once again. So here it should get display. If you connect your mobile, your device name should be displaying over here, so that you can install the thing. So one second, we will wait. So what I have said, when your device is not connected, what you need to do? So you need to check with the USB connections, all the things. You need to give us an option. You need to stay away. You need to stay awake. So I will go with the developer option. And I will keep stay awake. Then I will keep next. Still not displaying. Okay, anyone who are having the emulator, wait, we make the connection one second. Okay, one second, guys. I will close and open the same thing. Android Studio. So you should remember when you are developing ID, and if you want to give any color of your own, or if you want to give any own strings, you need to specify in the color.xml and string.xml, and if you want to specify any dimensions, you should be in the dimensions.xml file. All these three folders will be in the values folder. So you need to have a check with that before you give your own color, strings, or any dimensions. So if you're performing an event handler function for any buttons, you should have an onClick attribute. So whatever the value we will give for that particular attribute, that particular function should be there in your Java file. So see here, I have got a device, Samsung 31 something SM. The name, whatever the device you will connect, it will display over here. So I will run this particular application. So let's see how it runs. So as soon as it completed, I will connect my phone so that you can see the how the event handler will occur. So the Gradle build process is running. So now this build process is going on for this particular project. So it takes some few minutes to build the process. Depending on your RAM, it takes time. If your RAM is 16 GB, Gradle build process will be faster. So now the Gradle build finished. So now the app, particular app, is installing. I will change this. I will go with the mobile so that you can see. See, operation successful. The application has been installed. I will share my screen. Okay. I will stop this. And I will run once again so that I'm running the application. See, the, as soon as you run, see success, operation succeeded. So here, the app has been installed. I will enter number 4 and I will enter number 3. If I perform addition operation, the result is 8. See, one more thing I will do. So now I am going to change the text color and everything I am going to change. I will increase the size. I will increase the text size to 24 dp. So here also I will make exercise 24 dp, and to view the result, the text size 24 dp. So I will stop this running an application, and again I will run the application. If you make any changes, it will take time. It has been 9. See, I will enter 5 + 1. The result is 6. So as soon as you click, it will perform. So if I enter -6, it's a minus. This is how the event handling will happen. Event handler will happen as soon as you click by using the on click attribute. Okay.